Hello viewers, now we are going into the components of skill of reinforcement. So it consists of four components as you have seen here. The first is positive verbal reinforcement, the second is positive non-verbal reinforcement, third one negative verbal reinforcement, fourth one negative non-verbal reinforcement. So reinforcement consists of four sub-components. So instead of going through the components, let me tell about some theory. After that we will come back to the components. The theory is Skinner's theory of learning. So Skinner's theory of learning, just for this alone we would like to see. And this theory of learning comes under SR theory, theory of learning, where S is called stimulus, R is response. Suppose if I ask a question, that question is stimulus. If students are responding to that, then that is called response. So that answer is response. This stimulus and response will become learning. The connection between stimulus and response is called as a learning. To increase the connection or to make it more strong, what we do is called reinforcement. Suppose I have joined in a college as a teacher, I will be getting my salary. You think that if I am getting a salary for the first year, some amount, and for the second year the same amount, for the third year the same amount, for the fourth year same amount. If I am getting the same salary again and again and again, then I will be dejected. Therefore, what they will do, they will put yearly increment. So first year I'll get some amount of salary, the second year I'll get little bit enhanced salary, third year I'll be getting further enhanced salary. So likewise, that motivates me, so that provides me a small reinforcement. Likewise, if there is a student, if I ask one question, if the student is answering correctly, then I will say very good, correct, wonderful, like that. So these provides reinforcement. If you are not saying the good words to the students, they may not answer further. You know, no. So suppose if you are in class, if some students are answering correctly, then we have to motivate them. So like this motivation forms as what you call as reinforcement. So reinforcement cements between the stimulus and responses. If this is not there, this will part. And there will be no connection between stimulus and response. If there is no connection, and there will be no learning. Therefore, to have the connection, we have to reinforce the students. This reinforcement, we have some kinds. These are the kinds. Now we will come to here. Generally, there are two categories. One depends upon the verbal and non-verbal. Suppose you use words. To motivate, you use words. So if you use words, then that is called verbal. Instead of using words, if you use gestures, then that is called non-verbal. Again, the reinforcement is divided into another type, which we call it as positive and negative. So one is positive, the other one is negative. So based on these two categories, based on verbal category and positive negative, we have four type: positive verbal, positive non-verbal, negative verbal, negative non. These are the combinations, permutation and combination. So now let us understand what this means. So previously we said reinforcement is the one which cements the stimulus and response, or it enhances the occurrence of responses again and again. Response will come more and more. Therefore, we have to give reinforcement. If you motivate by saying words, very good, wonderful, beautiful, aha, like that, something you are saying. So by hearing that word, students will be getting motivated, then that is called positive verbal reinforcement. Instead of using verbal words, you are using like it's good, victory, they will show V for victory sign, they will show it's good means they will show like this. If you are using any other things, non-verbal gestures, then that is called as positive non-verbal reinforcement. Okay, now let us go for the negative concept. This negative concept, literally it means that, suppose if you use words, you are idiot, in your brain what is there, whether it is mud or any other brain, like that we will tell. So in that manner we should not take. Negative verbal reinforcement is some other kind, where again I will explain with this theory, little more explanation. Suppose if I want to smoke, what I will think? I will think if I am smoking, my students will see me that I am smoking. They will tell, see my teacher is smoking, why should not I smoke? Like that they will think. Therefore, being a teacher, I won't be smoking, thinking that later on I can't ask my students why you are smoking. Therefore, thinking those things, I won't smoke. Thinking those negative reinforcements. If I do this, if I smoke, I will get negative reinforcement. My student will scold me, administration will scold me, and I cannot be a judge for my students. These are negative reinforcements. To avoid this negative reinforcement, I won't be smoking. I will leave the smoking. Therefore, the simple thing is, positive means we will take in to give the response. Negative means we will avoid to give the response. So this negative reinforcement, we have to avoid it to give good responses. So positive reinforcements will be taken inside and negative reinforcement will be left. It will not be taken by the organism. So the organism leave the negative reinforcement to give a better response. So in that way we have to take. Therefore, verbal means we should not use unparliamentary words, but we have to be a little bit motivation. But students, they should think, teacher will scold me. They think that they will do the homework. If I go tomorrow, if I am not submitting the assignment, teacher will scold me. Therefore, I will do the assignment. Therefore, this is for verbal and another for non-verbal. Even this also, they will avoid to produce good responses. Okay, so by this way we have understood all the four components: positive verbal, positive non-verbal, negative verbal, and negative non-verbal components. Thank you.